Mga kaibigan, nandito po tayo sa actual Titi Races kung saan nagkakaroon na po ng tinatawag na rehearsal. Dahil hindi naman po tayo makapasok, narinig lang po natin kung gaano kabilis at kaharurot ang mga sasakyan ng mga motorbikes dito. At sa kasamaang palad, meron pong nasawi kahapon sa pagiging dangerous at napakabilis ng takbo ng mga motorsiklo. Aalamin po natin ang mga detalye. Pero in the meantime, para pong karnabal dito sa TT Races, dito lamang po sa Isle of Man. Nangyayari na po ngayon for the next 2 weeks. It's the biggest, most dangerous, ayan po, nadidinig nyo, race in a town.
By next to nothing the other night. I think it was 1/10 of a mile an hour, and we're just waiting for them to reach the lap, and we'll see where they slot in. Harry Payne does slot in. He's now the third fastest out of pit pole.
So fortunate here to have two of my friends, Carol and Cliff Davis. They used to live in the Philippines for a few years. How long did you stay there, Carol?
We were there 7 years.
Yes, wow. How does it feel that the TT is back after 2 years away from COVID?
It's absolutely amazing. The volume of people that are coming through and the atmosphere is fantastic. And it's only just getting started. So yeah, we're going to have a great time.
Are you? Do you encounter having guests that you entertain at home
We have people who used to come and visit us many years ago before we went to Manila. So some of them are going to come and visit, and especially Joe the Jeweler. He's hoping to come over very soon.
So we're looking forward
to that.
And Cliff, as a man, what's so exciting about TT?
It's just fantastic. The Isle of Man, as many people know, is the motorcycle road racing capital of the world. Just look around you now and feel the excitement. It is wonderful to see so many enthusiastic motorsports people coming here to the Isle of Man to have such a wonderful time and be part of this world famous festival.
It is world famous, but sorry to ask about this. What about the danger? Because we know that there was a death yesterday. How do you feel about that?
Well, motorcycling, the competitors, they know what the risks and the dangers are, and it is as safe as any as other motorsports. The professionals, the regulations are there, and they're doing everything to enhance the safety of it. But Tessie, I'll tell you what I'll do. Tomorrow I'll get my Triumph Rocket out and we'll go for a spin around the course. I'll show you all 37 and 3/4 miles of it.
You better do that. Huh?
And then you can answer the question yourself.
Yes, I will. Thank you.
That'll be fun.
Yes, I look forward to that.
Mabuhay.
Hello there. Here with two really funky, very handsome visitors. Well, this is Anthony and
Luke.
From where do you come from?
UK, Kent.
UK. Yes, of course. So, how many years have you been coming to the TT races?
Since 2013.
Yes. What do you enjoy most? Please enter the frame.
Oh, all of it.
All of it.
The people, the place, bikes, all of it.
Yes. What's so thrilling about the actual race? They say it's the most dangerous. Look.
Yeah, it's just people putting their lives at risk for our entertainment, really. You can't beat it, can you? Really.
That's right.
You know, you get to appreciate it, ride around it, see what they're doing, and enjoying it.
Are you also a biker?
Yeah, unfortunately. Yeah.
Unfortunately. Do you imagine yourself participating in this race at all? Why not?
They've got something about the races. They've got it in them. They've got the skills, and that's what they do, and that's what we all, you know.
What about you? Do you think you would one day have the guts to do it?
Too old.
Too old. How old should one start?
Younger the better, really.
The younger the better.
Yeah.
I don't mean to inject a sad note, but what do you think of the death yesterday?
It's horrible. It's horrible.
Yes. Right. Do you think he really rode too fast? What do you think happened?
No, it's just, it's part of the sport, unfortunately. It's the sad side of the sport. It can't be helped sometimes. You know, sort of condolences to their families and people they've left behind, but he was doing what he loved. And yeah, and that's basically all we all should do. Do what you love and enjoy every moment.
Now, I'm so intrigued. What made you wear those terrific hairdos and the wigs?
It's taken years to grow. A lot of shampoo and a lot of patience with the shower plug.
Thank you. You're so much fun. Thank you. Salamat po ako dahil kasama ko dito si Angie. Nakita niyo na siya sa ibang vlogs ko. Hi Angie, kwento mo nga ano ang feeling ng isang wife. Kamukha mo si Dave dati. Nagre-racing din dati sa ano ang tawag doon, yung
pedicab.
Sidecar. Sa sidecar. Anong pakiramdam noon? Ininervous ka ba?
Nakakatakot talaga. It's very scary because you don't know what's going to happen. Lalo na pag lumabas na sila and it's like about more than 50 miles circuit, so you have to wait until na matapos talaga lahat.
Okay, paano mo siya na-convince na umi-stop na ng pagbabike?
Well, we have a family to look after, children, uh-oh, and it's very risky to, uh-oh, ano, na mag-racing kasi di mo alam kung accidents. Every year may namamatay talaga, so nakakatakot talaga.
Anong sabi niya sa'yo? No, nahirapan ka ba convince siya o hindi naman?
He was getting older too, so nag-mechanic na lang siya instead of being a racer. Mekaniko na lang siya sa kaibigan niya.
Okay, thank you. Nandito po tayo sa area ng grandstand kung saan naglalabasan pa rin itong mga sumali sa single bike practice race today. Magpapaalam na po ako. Alam ko medyo panlalaki itong ating naging topic na ito, pero para lang makita niyo po kung gaano ang transformation ng Isle of Man sa dami ng mga 10 to 20,000 bikers na pumupunta dito sa loob ng 2 linggo dahil dito sa world-renowned event na dinadayo ng lahat. Isa sa pinaka-colorful at ganun din po. Medyo delikado o dangerous na event. Ano po? So hanggang dito na lang po ang test tube on TT Races here in the Isle of Man. Bye!